All right, welcome to FixedByDoc, and today I have a packing list that I'm going to show you. That is, I didn't create this packing list. This is not my packing list. This packing list is given out by the instructors for the WIlderness Stewardship course that I'll be taking in January. It's a 12-day course out in the woods, wilderness for middle of winter. And the packing list is based on going on a group expedition, and everything that the course requires us to take is right here in this poke sled, with the exception of a couple of items. One, they are going to issue us a stove to use on the trip. No, I don't get to keep the stove. I wanted to bring my own stove, but they want everybody to have the same exact identical stove. So I guess if something happens to one or two of the stoves, they can interchange parts to repair and keep as many working stoves together as they can at any given time. Or so that if something happens and you have to use somebody else's stove, they don't have to teach over and over and over everybody how to use each different stove. So, and then, let's see. They are also giving out tents. They want everybody to have the exact same kind of tent to sleep in. Now, for medical reasons, I won't be sleeping in a tent personally. I'll be using my hammock system. But all the other students will be sleeping in either quinsies or tents. Now, I will be building snow quinsies with them. I just won't be sleeping in them because I'm not going to sleep on the hard ground. So. Anyways, besides with my back injuries and whatnot, it's more sensible for me to use the hammock. Anyway, so, with that said, I'll go ahead and show you, the poke sled I made myself. Most of the gear in this sled is, I say half of the gear in this sled is brand new. The other half is, gear that I've had for a while. A lot of the brand new gear, was purchased for me by my scholarship, because I'm currently getting a second bachelor's degree in outdoor recreation, leadership and management, and I'm on 100% scholarship. So basically anything I need or require in order to complete the degree, my scholarship buys for me. Basically if the class puts it on the syllabus saying you have to have this, if I don't already own it, then the scholarship buys it. So some of the stuff is bought through scholarship. Some of it I bought on my own. Some of it I've had for a while. And some of it I made. One of the things I made was this belt here. I assembled from parts and pieces. This is my poke sled belt. Goes on here. These are my poles for my poke sled. And I unscrew that, slip my poke sled pole inside there, and the other end of the pole attaches to the sled, obviously. And so this works really well. This way I don't have to carry a backpack, but I do have my snacks and food for today. I do have this pouch here opens up and expands pretty large. Almost 15-20 liters, and I can put all my layers that I strip out of, and in this pouch right here gets my first aid and survival equipment. So at the end of the day, when we get to a base camp and we want to set up base camp, we want to go out for a day hike, I can take the poles off, and I've got everything right here in these pockets and this belt to go for my day hikes. And it's not like wearing a big full backpack, so there's no weight on my back, and there's everything I need right there. It helps keep me cooler, even though we're going to be in the middle of winter, still going to do a lot of overheating if you're pulling a poke sled, wearing a backpack, snowshoeing, and hiking through the wilderness. You're going to heat up quite a bit. We will be doing a lot of this course on skis. I've never skied before in my life, and so I'm hoping this course will teach me how to ski, They promised they would anyway. If I didn't mention it, this class, this wilderness stewardship class, is a mandatory class that I have to take if I want to graduate. These are my ski poles. So this is a rosin all set. This pouch here is the pouch that I made last summer to go on my trekking poles. It carries my snacks, sunflower seeds, whatever, camera equipment. Okay, and then my Rosinal snow boots. I chose this style boot because they slip right into my Neo over boots really well. So I have them like this when I'm skiing, and then when we switch over to the snowshoes, all I do is slip my Neo over boot over this with my gaiters, and then I put them right into my snowshoes and keep on hiking, and I don't have to change out boots or anything. And next here, this poke sled I did make last year, used it with Medic Jim on our winter hang from last year, so I'm just using the same poke sled that I had. These are my snowshoes I've had since the winter of 2005, I believe. I got these from Walmart, and they're Yukon Charlies, but they may be a cheap knockoff snowshoe, but they're damn good ones. Sometimes you can find inexpensive stuff that actually works, and those do. Okay, these are my Baffin pack boots. They are 100% waterproof, and they have a kind of a gator top style removable liner and everything. I'll go in more detail with those later. They're rated negative 148 degrees. I have my snow shovel here. Hardened anodized aluminum snow shovel made by Lifeline, and very good snow shovel. Very strong, very sturdy. I will be getting a second one of those snow shovels because after this trip, or when I'm not camping, one of those snow shovels will be in each of our vehicles. Here's a large bag of clothing that they tell us we have to have. I'll go through that here in a few minutes. These are my Neo's pack boots, or sorry, Neo's over boots. And they're just waterproof material with a rubber sole and some metal cleats on here that can be removed. And all they do is slip over your existing boot, so that the only boots I'm carrying out there are my Rosinal ski boots and my Baffin pack boots and these. So when we're hiking, I'll always be in my ski boots. When we're sitting around camp not doing anything, I'll be in my Baffin boots. When I'm sleeping, I will be in my down booties, which are right here. And then when if I get up in the middle of the night and have to go somewhere, I just slip my my Neo's over boots right over these. So that way I don't have to carry a whole bunch of three different sets of boots, one for skis, one for snowshoeing and hiking, and one for sitting around camp. You know, thankfully they're letting us mix and match like that. These are my Kindertruck snow gaiters. And we have to have a pair of snow goggles, and goggles or sunglasses. And since I wear glasses, I opted to get the goggles because they fit over my glasses. This particular pair is designed to be worn while you're wearing eyeglasses, so that's really nice. And they look pretty cool, I think, anyway. I hope everything's getting on camera. If not, don't worry, because you'll get to see it when I'm on my trip at some point. I mentioned I will be sleeping in a hammock, so I got my Kelty Noah Tarp 9x9. And my Eno hammock, my Eno Ember underquilt, and my winter socks that I'll be sleeping in are in here, and my I have a pair of gloves in here, polypro gloves that I'll be wearing if my fingers hands get cold while I'm sleeping. And so that's good. And then here's my North Face snowshoe 0 degree sleeping bag. So with that system right there, I've gotten down to negative 17, I believe. So my mess kit, I'm bringing my the same 1 liter pot I use in the summertime on all my other trips. But I'm also bringing a second pot, which is basically my eating bowl. Now, if you know me, normally I eat out of the same pot I cook in, but we're going as a group, and there's going to be 12 people and four groups of three, and we have to cook together and eat together and everything else. So when we cook something, we're not just cooking for ourselves, we're cooking for other people as well, so we each have to have a bowl to eat out of. And I opted for the MSR Seagull pot. It's the pot with a lid. So I can boil snow in here. I could cook in here if I had to. It's primarily for eating out of. And it's got a lid so that I don't have to worry about somebody kicking it over or whatever. A lid that locks in place. Okay, then I have the insulated hydro flask, 40 ounce, 1.8 liter, insulated thermos, stainless steel, no glass or anything, double walled. It keeps stuff hot for a pretty long time, keeps stuff cold for a pretty long time, so whatever you put in it, it's gonna stay the way you want it for a while. Then I got my coffee mug, insulated coffee mug here for soup, coffee, whatever. Thermo insulated leather gloves for working with the stoves and stuff. They want us to have leather gloves, even though we're not allowed to have campfires and won't be holding a set, making any campfires or anything like that. When we're working with the stoves, they say we have to have leather gloves on. So, got a pair of leather gloves. And I have a pair of mittens. They require us to have a pair of mittens with a removable liner. And these are pretty cool. They have a little frost scraper here for my goggles. And they're mittens, so they can keep me nice and warm. They're waterproof, windproof mittens. They're specifically made for snowmobiling. So they should do me just fine for sitting around camp when we're doing our classes. And they have a removable kind of a fleecy type material liner. Another feature they have on them is the wrist strap and a draw cord up here so you can cinch them down so that it doesn't let any snow get in this way. So some pretty cool features here. Okay. And then I have my Primus, I think it's a 0.8 liter kettle. This particular one is brand new. I got it at Switchback for 10 bucks. There's a gear tester, used it once, did write a review on it for Backpacker Magazine, and then she sold it at Switchback for 10 bucks. So I got a deal on that. It's the exact same one I have that I've been using all summer long. So I got one for me and one for my wife now. Okay, moving along. We have to carry a second 40 ounce canteen. So I'm using my Nalgene here with a reflective cozy for it. And of course, at nighttime, I'll be putting it in upside down so that it'll freeze here. So when I open it up, it'll always be liquid on the top. That way. my map roll, keep my map nice and dry. Got that from Medic Jim last year, I think. Have a spare tarp, which is the one that's reflective. Where is it? Reflective on the inside. And then I have some full-length reflective padding, so I can put this in between my hammock and my underquilt if it gets really cold. Or I can lay this on the ground, or I can fold it up, set it on the ground and sit on it, whatever. Somebody gets hypothermic, you can put that under them and then wrap them in the tarp. All kinds of uses for that stuff. Okay, let's see. Here, I have a repair kit. I believe I've done a review on this before, but basically everything you would need to repair all this gear is in this pouch. Then this container here is empty right now, but it holds 8 tea light candles. And I have my tea light candle lantern. And yes, the tea light candle lantern is on their packing list. They want, most of the time while we're out there, we'll be building snow quinsies if we actually have enough snow to do so. And the other people will be sleeping in those quinsies, obviously in the hammock. And they will are required to have tea light candles so that they can heat up their quinsies. It'll be interesting to see how much a tea light candle can actually heat a place up. I've heard that they can, just having one little candle inside of a quinsy that's been properly made and just the right size for two people, you can keep it around with two people in it and a tea light candle around 35 to 38 degrees. So we'll see. Let's see. We're allowed to bring one toy, so I'm bringing my night vision scope. And so I really like playing around with my night vision scope. This is the Night Owl Optics Night Vision. If you live where I live, the atmosphere is so clear, and especially at nighttime when there's no clouds, pull out a pair of night vision and look up at the stars. It's really nice. Okay, bathroom supplies. A bunch of toilet paper, some baby powder, and my medicine for my migraines. I'm bringing a knife. And even though we're not going to have campfires, my knife, I don't go anywhere without my flint. You never know, there might be an emergency where we need one. And then I have my Polypro top, hat, and a pair of regular Cirrus, I think you pronounce it, fleece gloves. Magnesium flint bar, whistle, and watch, which will be on my person while we're out running about. And my new headlamp has green light and white light. Very bright. I'll do a review on that later. And I bring a couple of big lighters. My Gerber suspension multi-tool for, so I have a pair of pliers and whatnot that I need to repair the gear. And then this is my camera mount that allows me to attach my camera to my hiking poles. And of course, a compass, map cards, and a notebook, all right here. And then we have two school books that we have to bring out. I don't have those right here with me. They are in the house somewhere. But. And then I got some of those. These are foot warmer ones, and these are the hand ones. You open them up, they get hot, supposedly. I don't normally use them, but everybody swears by them, so I'm going to bring some out just in case. And as many as I can stuff in my pocket. So, there you have it. Oh, forgot my clothes bag. So, let's see, let's make some room here. As you can see, it's an awful lot of gear. And personally, I wouldn't be taking this much gear. It's only 12 days in the wilderness, and they're having us pack as if we're spending the rest of our lives out there. So, I'm not teaching the course, so I have to abide by what the instructors want us to take. And this course was based on the WEA course, Wilderness Education Association. They've made some changes to it and whatnot. So anyways, this is all the gear that they require us to take. Now, they want us to bring several bandanas and clothing to wear while we're just sitting around the camp, not doing anything but doing our lectures and our classes. I got a down jacket liner to be worn inside my parka. I don't know if I showed this earlier. This is the coat I'm bringing. It's basically it's a thin layer. How do you say this? It's a parka. It's waterproof, windproof parka. It does have some insulation, but not a lot. This coat here relies on liners, and this down jacket here is one of its liners. I have a whole layering system that we'll be using out there, so I can strip a layer off at a time and build a layer up if I need to. And the pants that we're wearing while we're just sitting around, my Gore-Tex snow pants here. I tried these out yesterday on the trail. None of the snow stuck to them. They didn't get wet. They're supposed to be windproof and waterproof. They did turn out to be waterproof, but they weren't quite windproof, so go figure. When I say waterproof, I say that I was in the snow and playing around in the snow, and I didn't get wet. And the snow did not stick to it, even though it's kind of a soft, weird, soft material. But the heavy gusts of wind did blow through those. So wearing those with a pair of polypro pants or fleece pants, they should actually do quite nice. Let's see. Waterproof, windproof, Tech 2O breathable, polypro here, or sorry, not polypro, a balaclava here. I used this last winter and it works awesome. And it happens to be kind of the same material almost. It's not Gore-Tex, but it's a similar feel to the pants, and then the pattern matches, so that's great. And then I have a thin layer balaclava here. And then my primary pants. Oh, sorry, this is my jacket. My waterproof, windproof jacket, which does work very well. And it's just a basic thin layer jacket. So if it's too warm because we're hiking, skiing, snowshoeing, or whatever, to wear my parka, then I'll be wearing this one as a windbreaker. And then the pants to go with that windbreaker top is right here. These will be my primary pants. I have a full side zipper and cargo pockets and everything. They're waterproof, windproof, and flexible. So they flex at the knees and the front and the back and the hips and everything, so that they kind of stretch so that you don't tear them. A couple pairs of underwear, one synthetic and two cotton. And a spare pair of pants. These are my backup pants. They're the military level 5, five-layer system. These are the outer shells. These are very water resistant. I'd almost say waterproof, because they are listed on their tag as water resistant, but I've worn them out in the pouring down rain and I didn't get wet. I've knelt in the snow, didn't get wet. So even though they say they're water resistant, I'm more leaning towards waterproof from personal experience with them. They are half zip. They zip down the sides to the cargo pocket, and they zip up to the cargo pocket. So they're half zip in each direction. Three pairs winter hiking socks. Two thin layer Under Armour shirts, too thin layer under our pants. Two polypro tops. And these particular polypro tops that I'll be taking are actually covered in my dog's fur. So I think they, my dogs have decided that I need some extra insulation, but so they added some fur to my polypros. So there's two polypro tops and then one polypro bottom and one fleece bottom. Now, they didn't want me bringing all polypro. They said I had to bring either wool or fleece, but I talked them into letting me bring polypro, and they said if I was bringing all polypro, I had to bring, for my mid layers we're talking about, then I had to bring at least one pair of fleece. So I brought one fleece bottoms. I don't really have a complaint about fleece or about polypro. It's just I tend to lean towards polypro because I'm as an Army soldier, a combat medic, and that's what they issued us. That's what I like. I like the polypros. They feel good. They do exactly what I want them to do, and they keep me exactly as warm as I want them to keep me. And fleece pretty much do the exact same thing. It's just, I don't know, kind of like polypro. So, anyways, we did a, after collecting all this gear, then we went and did an overnight, December 14th, we went out and did an overnight with the class, and they went through all of our gear and checked it all, and basically, I have everything that was on the list that was required me to have. The only thing they complained about after negotiations with some of the gear, the only thing they complained about was my coat, because they, our coat has to be 3 to 4 inches aloft and really big, poofy, and fluffy. And I'm like, no, I'm going to bring out a coat that you can be layered, and a coat system that I know works for me. I tend to get hot real fast and then stay hot for a long time, even after after we go for a snowshoe hike, for example. I'll get real hot in the first 10 minutes, and then I'll stay hot for the rest of the time that we're hiking. And then when we come to a stop and take a break, I'll retain that heat for a good 30, 40 minutes. So wearing a big coat with 3 to 4 inches aloft, I'm gonna burn up. And even if I just used it for sitting around the campsite not doing anything, I could put on my thin layer, my mid layer, and my coat. And if I was still cold, I could put on my thin layer, my mid layer, my down jacket, and my coat. And if I'm still cold after that, then something is seriously wrong, because that right there should get me down to negative 30, easy, because what my system is rated at. So I went and talked to the head professor at the school, and they said that I can use my parka. So I did, that was the one item I did go over the head of the instructor and got permission from a higher ranking source. Other than that, this is all the gear. So I know it's kind of a long video. Hope you enjoyed it. Get a quick idea of what I'm required to take for this trip. And while we're out on the trip, I will take as much video as I'm capable of taking, and I'll try to take a bunch of pictures too. Not sure exactly how it's going to go, because it is a kind of a class. It's not like taking out my Boy Scouts or going out on my own or going with Medic Jim. It is more of going out in a structured environment where I am the student, so I don't know how much I will be able to videotape. But I will try to get as much as I can, and hopefully you'll get to see all this stuff in use. So, alright, thanks for watching FixedByDoc. Have a good day.